In this video, we'll demo epoch delta analysis function in Cisco Network Strength Engine, NAE. NAE allows you to choose any two epochs along the timeline to perform epoch delta analysis. It does delta analysis for health and policy. So to access epoch delta function on the UI, you go to epoch delta tab, and the first thing you need to do is select Manage Delta Analysis and to create your Epoch Delta instance. So click on Create New Epoch Delta Analysis here, and you give it a name, and then you need to choose earlier epoch and later epoch. So you can click on the epoch dot along the timeline to choose that epoch. For example, I click the first one and choose it as my early epoch. Or you can just use the drop-down menu to choose any available epoch here. And then you go select your later epoch. Of course, you need to select an epoch which is after your earlier epoch. You can, again, click on the epoch dot along the timeline or use the drop-down menu. Once you're done with the selection, you can click on the Run button, and it's going to create your epoch data analysis instance and start to queue and run it. So I already have a couple of delta analysis created and run prior to this recording. So let's look at one of them. So you go on the right hand to click on the gear button, and then you can actually select view results. It takes you to the delta analysis page. And here you can see there are two different types of delta analysis, health delta and policy delta. Health delta represents, you know, operational states differences between the two epochs. Actually, we do a difference analysis between the smart events of the two epochs and show the user the differences, right, for each smart event severity, critical, major, minor, warning, and information. And for each one of them, we have two circles. The left one represents the earlier epoch, and then the right one, the later epoch. So the number on the left hand, on the left is the number of smart events that only existed in the earlier epoch, and they are not in the later epoch. And then the number on the right side are the new events that only exist in the newer, later epoch, and they were not in the earlier epoch. The number in the middle are the overlapping smart events. So they were in both earlier and later epoch, right? So those differences actually give you indication of, you know, are the operational status are different between these two epochs or not. And here, in this example, my newer later epoch has one new critical event. Right, so I can click into this event and then open this report and learn more details about this event. And switch over to the policy delta. Here is the configuration delta between these two epochs. On this page, on the left-hand side the column, it shows you the objects which had configuration changes between the two epochs. And in the middle, it shows you the detailed information, detailed changes, right? So what has been changed. And on the right-hand side is the audit log about those configuration changes. So coming back to the left-hand side, if I choose this bridge domain subnet and I choose show change, it's going to show me the particular change related to this subnet. And you can see here, right? So it, for this EPI subnet, its scope was changed from private to public. And on the right hand, this column, it shows me the corresponding audit log. It shows me the admin user made this change at 12:45, 22 p.m. PDT, March 26. So that's all you need to know, like, about configuration changes, right? So why is epoch delta analysis important or useful for network team? Think about different scenarios. One, like when some network issue happened. So if you have epoch collected before the issue and you have epoch, another epoch collected after the issue, and you do a diff analysis, and then the health delta will give you a strong indication about what could be the issue, what change in the network, and you can actually start or speed up your troubleshooting process. And the policy delta actually could be also more, even more useful, right? Because we know that a lot of network issues were caused by configuration changes. Somebody changed something in the config and then caused a problem. So coming to here to the policy delta between before and after epochs, then you can actually get very good idea about what changed, and then you can actually further analyze if these changes are could be contributing to that issues you're troubleshooting. And another scenarios are, for example, your maintenance window, right? You are doing software upgrade for your network. So before and after delta analysis here gives you indication, like if your network has converged after the software upgrade, or if anything has changed, or anything you know has been missing, right? So that's why epoch delta analysis is a very useful function offered by NAE to the data center operational team. And this concludes this video. Thank you for watching.